Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 27th, 2019. No hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, U.S. forces leave Iraq towards oil fields in Syria, Saturday. October 26, 2019 10:57 p.m., a convoy of the U.S. forces were photographed on Saturday as crossing the Iraqi border towards the oil fields in neighboring Syria. Local sources told Kurdistan 24 that the U.S. convoy was heading to Deir al-Zor to protect the oil fields there, as it had already been hinted by U.S. President Donald Trump in a statement on his Twitter account. Earlier this month, President Trump announced Washington's plans to withdraw all U.S. troops from Syria while repeatedly saying that they would not fight the ISIS while it is thousands of miles away from the United States. He, however, said later that a small number of U.S. forces will remain in northern Syria to make sure the oil fields the U.S. and Kurdish forces took back from the ISIS group will be secured. The return of the forces comes while Turkey and Russia have already agreed on renewing the Adana Pact, according to which Ankara and Damascus will cooperatively take control of part of the border areas, with Russian police forces to be responsible for the other part of the region. Next article of interest, Khalidi, cabinet changes will not extinguish the flames of demonstrations, 27 October, 2019, MP Mohammed Al-Khalidi, Sunday that the vents of all ministerial changes by Prime Minister Del Abdul Adi will not extinguish the flames of demonstrations, pointing out that calm depends on the situation of the resignation of the overmint and come to a UN-dependent government and an end to the WADA system file in the outry. Khalidi said in a statement to the information that the ministerial changes made by the Prime Minister will not work, as it was better to implement the government program from the beginning in order to avoid the arrival of the situation to what it is now. He added that the situation in Iraq is very difficult, and the bloodshed during the demonstrations will not be resolved by administrative matters, but there will be a judiciary and courts to hold accountable those who are offenders and guilty of the people. He explained that the solution to the current problem lies in the change of government and the arrival of non-partisan personalities, with away from quotas in all positions, noting that the replacement of the entire government is much better than making some changes in the joints. He pointed out that the amendment of the Constitution is very difficult, as the amendment must be approved by everyone from different components and in all provinces in accordance with Article 142 of the Constitution. Next article of interest, Iraqi cleric SADR's political allies go into opposition. Baghdad Reuters. A parliamentary bloc backed by populist Shiite cleric Muqtada al-Sadr said on Saturday it would go into opposition until demands of anti-government protesters who flocked to the streets defying a violent security crackdown were met. The Sarun bloc, an alliance of SADR followers, communists, and other parties, is the largest in Iraq fragmented parliament with 54 seats out of 329. The Sarun parliamentary bloc announces that it will go into opposition inside the House of Representatives and declares a sit-in inside parliament until the protesters' legitimate demands are met, a spokesman said at a news conference. Sarun, which came first in the 2018 election, did not specify if its representatives would resign from government. SADR, a 45-year-old mercurial cleric who presents himself as a man of the people, is backing the ongoing wave of anti-government protests against corruption and economic hardship. He issued a statement of support for the demonstrators earlier on Saturday as the overall death toll this month rose to more than 200. Protesters have called on Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi to resign. Abdul Mahdi was a compromise candidate between SADR bloc and their main rivals, an alliance of Iran-backed Shiite militia leaders. That alliance, Fatih, issued a statement on Saturday in support of security forces and called on the premier to be firmer in cracking down on protesters who resorted to violence. Next article of interest. Security expert reveals the role of Iraqi intelligence in the killing of Baghdadi, October 27, 2019 10:24. The strategic expert in the affairs of armed groups Hisham al-Hashemi, on Sunday, the role of Iraqi intelligence in the killing of ISIS terrorist leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. Al-Hashemi said in an interview with Al-Furat News that in most cases, The killing of Baghdadi establishes a period of silence and laziness in terrorist operations, as happened after the killing of Abu Omar al-Baghdadi. Al-Qaeda took 4 months to activate its operations again. He added that this inactivity and laziness may extend until the end of the dispute over who succeeds Baghdadi, and I think that the caliphate came out of Iraq is between Tunisian or Algerian. He stressed that Iraqi intelligence contributed to provide very important information about the whereabouts of Baghdadi in Syria through a special cell U.S., British, Iraqi, noting that the Iraqis helped to disclose information about Baghdadi's attempt to transfer his family towards Turkey. Next article of interest, counter-terror forces deployed in Baghdad, October 27, 2019-6:56 p.m. Baghdad. Hundreds of thousands of Iraqis have protested against the government. Iraq's elite counter-terrorism service says it has deployed in the streets of Baghdad upon Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi's orders to protect important state buildings while security forces are busy with protests. Counter-terrorism service forces have been deployed in some areas of Baghdad to protect state buildings from undisciplined elements taking advantage of security forces being busy with protecting protests and protesters, it said in a statement on Sunday. Two security sources had told Reuters on Saturday that the elite counter-terrorism forces had been deployed in Baghdad and had been told to use all necessary measures to end ongoing protests against Mahdi's government. Protesters gathered across Iraq on Saturday in a second day of anti-government protests, in which at least 65 people have died. Next article of interest, Iraqi protesters dig in to bring down regime, Baghdad AFP October 27, 2019-10:04. Hundreds of protesters hunkered down in the Iraqi capital's Tahrir Square on Sunday, defying another night of tear gas and shuttered roads as they pledged to weed out the political class. They have continued to gather despite a rapidly rising casualty toll, with more than 60 people dead since the second wave of anti-government protests kicked off Thursday. "We are here to bring down the whole government, to weed them all out," one protester said. The Iraqi tricolor wrapped around his head. Government officials including Prime Minister Adel Abdel Mahdi and Parliament Speaker Mohamed Al-Albisi have suggested more than a dozen reforms, but demonstrators seem unimpressed. "We don't want a single one of them. Not Al-Albisi, not Abdel Mahdi. We want to bring down the regime," the protester said. The scene at Tahrir was chaotic, with some protesters climbing atop multi-story business centers to wave Iraqi flags and others torching tires in rubbish-littered streets. Large tents had been set up and volunteers were distributing food and water to demonstrators. Notably, women and students were seen in larger numbers. Two elderly women in traditional black robes and headscarves hopped up on a concrete barrier and waved the Iraqi flag while dancing to upbeat pop music. "I'm here for the generation that's coming," said one young woman who identified herself as a prenatal nurse. "Our generation is psychologically tired, but it's alright as long as this is for the next one," she said. Security forces were positioned on the edges of Tahrir, while elite counter-terrorism service troops and armored vehicles were seen in surrounding districts. The CTS said it had deployed its units to protect vital infrastructure, and its forces were not seen in Tahrir. The persistent protests have kept the pressure up on Abdel Mahdi, as has a new sit-in by parliamentarians tied to populist cleric Muqtada al-Sadr. His Haroun bloc, parliament's largest, launched the open-ended measure late on Saturday in order to achieve protester demands, lawmakers told AFP. Next article of interest, U.S. General, Baghdadi was sleeping with an explosive belt, October 27, 2019-11:22. Retired U.S. Air Force General Cedric Layton has highlighted previous intelligence reports that ISIS terrorist leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi was sleeping with an explosive belt. "There are intelligence reports that confirmed to the public years ago that Baghdadi was sleeping in a suicide belt," Layton said. He continued, "It seems that these reports were correct to prevent his arrest." Layton's comments come after a Pentagon source told CNN that Baghdadi detonated an explosive belt himself during an operation by a U.S. force in northwestern Syria on Saturday. Earlier, U.S. media said Baghdadi was killed by a U.S. raid approved by President Donald Trump. A senior Pentagon official said the ISIS leader was the target of a covert military operation in the Syrian province of Idlib. Next article of interest, Al-Mustansiriya University students strike in solidarity with the demonstrators, October 27, 2019-11:46. students of the University of Mestansiriya, on Sunday, went on strike in solidarity with the demands of the demonstrators of Tahrir Square. The correspondent Euphrates News that the students of the University of Mestansiriya began to strike and declared solidarity with the demands of the protesters in Tahrir Square. The Ministry of Higher Education and Scientific Research had revealed earlier, on Sunday, the fact that the issuance of orders for university students participating in the sit-ins. The media office of the ministry in an explanation, there is no truth to the news of the issuance of orders from the ministry for university students to participate in sit-ins this day. Next article of interest, UN decries loss of life in Iraq protests. Anti-government protests have killed at least 63 Iraqis since Friday. Baghdad, Iraq, October 26. Iraqi security forces block the road of the high-security green zone, where key government offices and foreign embassies are based, with concrete barriers during a protest against unemployment, corruption and lack of public services, at Tahrir Square in Baghdad, Iraq on October 26, 2019. Mertad Hasudani, Anadolu Agency Baghdad Ibrahim Saleh 27.10.2019. The UN Iraq envoy has condemned the loss of life and destruction of property amid mass protests that rocked several Iraqi provinces in recent days. At least 63 people have been killed and more than 2,500 injured since Friday in a fresh wave of demonstrations against government corruption and a lack of basic services. It is tragic and unsettling to witness the return of violence, deaths and injuries. Social media restrictions remained in place, while internet access was intermittent, said Janine Hennis Plassert, the UN Special Representative for Iraq, in a statement. She said armed groups are seeking to hinder stability in Iraq and undermine the people's right to protest. The protection of human life always comes first. Armed entities sabotaging the peaceful demonstrations, eroding the government credibility and ability to act, cannot be tolerated, she said. Iraq has come a long way, and cannot afford to slide back into a new cycle of violence. The UN envoy praised Iraqi forces for helping injured demonstrators and ensuring the free movement of medical units. Unlike during the first wave of protests earlier this month, all parties need to redouble their efforts on the ground to not only prevent provocations and unnecessary confrontations, but also to collectively stand against armed spoilers, she said. Discontent has been growing in Iraq in recent years due to rising unemployment and rampant corruption. Many in the country have limited access to basic services such as electricity and clean water. According to World Bank figures, Iraq's youth unemployment is around 25%. It is also ranked the 12th most corrupt country in the world according to several transparency organizations. Next article of interest. The Presidency of Parliament instructs deputies to attend tomorrow's session, 27th October. 2019. The MP of the Fatah Alliance Abbas Yabr al-Latafi, Sunday that the Presidency of the House of Representatives instructed deputies to attend a meeting on Monday to take important decisions. Al-Latafi said in TZRBH information that tomorrow's session will see the correction of many tracks down when the legitimate protesters want to freeze the work of the provincial councils and the questioning of a number of ministers and the dismissal of others. He added that the presidency of the House of Representatives instructed to hold a formal meeting tomorrow Monday and there is a large response from members of the council to take fateful decisions. Al-Latafi pointed out that on Monday will witness the termination of the work of the provincial, district and district councils in interrogation of the government. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.